Session will now come to order. Please rise for the Philippine National Anthem. Please remain standing for the opening prayer to be led by the Honorable George Bengua.
Let us pray the sanggunian panlaluigan prayer. Dear Lord, as we deliberate into this session, give us the wisdom to overcome passion. Give us the understanding heart to do away with prejudice. Give us the foresight to know what the future may devise. Give us the courage and strength to seek the truth in what is good. Give us the facility of language that we may be understood. And finally, our Lord, make us worthy public servants of this province. We deeply love and highly honor the province of Camarinesol, the premier province of Bicol region. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Honorable Bengua. May I request the Secretary to do the roll call?
Honorable Vice Governor Fortunato C. Peña.
Present.
Honorable Board Member Warren A. Senior. Honorable Board Member Romulo Hernandez. Honorable Board Member Darius S. Nopra. Honorable Board Member Fabio F. Figuracion. OB. Honorable Board Member Nelson B. Julia. Honorable Board Member Rodito P. Espiritu Jr. Honorable Board Member Angel G. Naval. Honorable Board Member Emmanuel H. Noble. Honorable Board Member Hilmar S. Pacamara. Honorable Board Member Amador L. Simando. Honorable Board Member Giovanni A. Senior. Honorable Board Member George R. Bengua. Chairman, I have the honor to certify the existence of a quorum.
Considering that we now have the quorum, we now proceed with our session. The Assistant Majority Floor Leader, the Honorable Board Member Simando, is now recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. At this juncture, may I move for the approval of the journal of the previous session.
Any second? Duly seconded by the Honorable Bengua. Any remarks, objection? Hearing none, the same is approved. Next item.
Approval of the agenda.
Any inclusion?
Yes, the Honorable Pacamara is recognized. After Honorable Pacamara, the Honorable Julia.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For inclusion, Mr. Chairman, a resolution ordinance authorizing Honorable Miguel Luis R. Villafuerte, Governor, Province of Camarinesul, to enter into a memorandum agreement by and between the Provincial Government of Camarinesul and the Department of Labor and Employment, Regional Office 5, through Mr. Nathaniel V. Lacambra, Regional Director DOLE, for the implementation of DOLE Integrated Livelihood and Emergency Employment Program and appropriate funds thereof. I move for the inclusion of this resolution under business for the day.
Under business for the day. Anybody seconding the motion? Duly seconded. Any objection? Hearing none, the same is approved. The
any
Honorable
other?
Julia.
Two resolutions, Mr. Chairman. Resolution condemning the ruthless killing of Barangay Captain Simeon Mendoza, Barangay Binanwaan ng Grande, Calabanga, Camarines Sur, and urging Philippine National Police and other law enforcement agencies to investigate for the past resolution of the case, and another resolution expressing deepest sympathy and condolences to the bereaved family of late Barangay Captain Simeon Mendoza, Barangay Binanwaan ng Grande, Calabanga, Camarines Sur. I move for its inclusion, Mr. Chairman, under business of the day.
Under business of the day. Anybody seconding the motion? Duly seconded by the Honorable Nopra and Bengwa. Any objection? Hearing none, the same is approved.
Any other inclusion?
The Honorable Nopra is recognized.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to avail of the privilege hour. It will take no more than 5 minutes, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, the Honorable Nopra will take a privilege hour. Any other inclusion?
May I be recognized, Mr. Chairman?
Yes, the Honorable Simando is recognized.
For inclusion, Mr. Chairman, proposed resolution authorizing the Governor Miguel Luis R. Villaverde on behalf of the provincial government of Camarines Sur to donate a portion of a parcel of land situated at Kadlan Pili, Camarines Sur, in favor of the Supreme Court of the Philippines that will be used as site of the Hall of Justice Pili, Camarines Sur. Proposed resolution authorizing Honorable Governor Miguel Luis R. Villaverde to enter into and sign a memorandum of agreement for and in behalf of the province of Camarines Sur with National Food Authority regarding the implementation of expanded rice loan program in the province of Camarines Sur. And finally, proposed resolution authorizing Governor Miguel Luis R. Villaverde on behalf of the province of Camarines Sur to donate 20 heads of deers to Hacienda de Naga Sports Club Incorporated. May I move, Mr. Chairman, for the inclusion of this proposed resolution under G3, business for the day.
Any second. Duly seconded by the Honorable Nopra. Any objection? Hearing none, the same is approved. Any other inclusions?
If there are no other inclusions, may I move, Mr. Chairman, for the approval of the agenda.
Any second. Duly seconded by the Honorable Bengwa and the Honorable Senyar, the agenda for today as amended is hereby approved.
Mr. Chairman, may I move for the suspension of the rules to give way to the resolution of commendation authored by Board Member Hilmar Pacamara, commending Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo, a native of Camarines Sur, for giving exemplary honors to the Philippines and most especially to the province of Camarines Sur for having been an outstanding graduate of LLM class of 2014 and elected graduation speaker at the commencement ceremony of the Columbia Law School, Columbia University of the City of New York, State of New York, and the United States of America.
Rule suspended. The Honorable Pacamara,
yes,
is now recognized.
Mr. Chairman, a minute recess for clarification.
Yang pun. Thank you. suspend mo ito. First reading ko yung palo yung pa.
Session will now resume. The Honorable Simando is recognized.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we tackle first the business for the day.
Yes, we first to accommodate our guests. We're jumping to the business for the day to give way to the resolution to be passed by, to be sponsored by the Honorable Pacamara. And we will go back to you later.
Okay. What's under first reading?
We will transfer this to the business for the day.
Okay. Mr. Chairman, may I request that if 2A, resolution designating or appointing Honorable Warren Senior, etc., be transferred to business for the day. And also the if 2A, 2, may I request also that the same be transferred to the business for the day. And also if 2A, 3, resolution commending Patrick Simon Perillo, to business for the day.
So, the three items under first reading are hereby transferred to the business for the day.
Also, Mr. Chairman, if 2A4 and if 2A5, we move that the same be transferred to G3 business for the day.
Another two items are hereby transferred for under business for the day. Okay, so what's the pleasure of the majority floor leader?
If three, Mr. Chairman, if 3A, if 3B, if 3C, are hereby referred to the appropriate committee, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, so all those items mentioned are hereby referred to the concerned committee as marked.
Also, E4A to E4H, we request that the same be referred to the appropriate committee.
Okay, so all mentioned items are hereby referred to the concerned committee as marked.
We come to item G, calendar of business committee reports. This is a committee report of the Committee on Franchise. Board Member Pacamara, may I move for the recognition of Board Member Pacamara?
I thought we'll be tackle now the business for the day.
So we escape calendar of business, the committee report, we tackle first the business for the day. And yes, we call on Ms. Board Member Pacamara with respect to his resolution of commendation.
Okay, the Honorable Pacamara is now recognized.
Again, thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. I have here, Mr. Chairman, a resolution commending Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo, a native of Camarines Sur, for giving exemplary honors to the Philippines and most especially to the province of Camarines Sur for having been an outstanding graduate of LLM class of 2014. and elected graduation speaker at the commencement ceremony of the Columbia Law School, Columbia University in the City of New York, State of New York, in the United States of America. Whereas Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo is a native of Camarines Sur, whose mother, Emelina Hugo C., hails from the town of Goa, Camarines Sur. A businesswoman and an active member of social, civic, and political organizations, and whose father, Simeon Perillo, is a successful businessman in the city of Naga. Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo, 30 years of age, is a member of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines since April 2009 and of the American Society of International Law since January 2014. Whereas Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo has studied at St. Joseph's School in Naga City and graduated there from kindergarten, elementary to high school with consistent honors. He completed his Bachelor of Science degree in Commerce in 2003, cum laude, at the La Salle University, Manila. He graduated with a Juris Doctor degree in 2008 at the Ateneo de Manila University School of Law, Makati City, Metro Manila. He received the Master of Laws in May 2014 at the Columbia Law School, Columbia University in the City of New York, USA. At De La Salle University in Manila, Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo was one of the top 1% of graduating class and received Jose Rizal Honors from 2001 to 2003. His co-authored thesis, A Close Scrutiny of the Supreme Court's Application of the Dominancy and Holistic Tests in Determining Trademarks Infringement, was considered as the third best thesis. Whereas at the Ateneo Law School in Makati, Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo was the president of the Ateneo Society of International Law. He also represented Ateneo and the Philippines in the Philip C. Jesup International Law Moot Court Competition in Washington, D.C. in 2007. Therein, his team was a judge champion in the national round, second best applicant memorial in the world Richard R. Baxter category, and fourth best memorials in the international rounds Alona E. Evans category. He was team captain of the Philippine Ateneo team to the Asia Cup International Law Moot Court Competition in Tokyo, Japan in 2006, where he was bestowed the Outstanding Achievement as Oralist Award and his team the Outstanding Achievement in Memorial Award. His law thesis, Transporting the Concept of Creeping Expropriation from the Legge Ferenda to the Legge Lata, Concretizing the Nebulous Under International Law, was awarded the Dean's Bronze Medal. Whereas at Columbia Law School in New York, USA, Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo was scholar of the Brad and Katie Smith Foundation, elected as the student senator, and was assistant executive editor of the Columbia Journal of Transnational Law. He graduated with the distinction of a Harlan Fiske-Stone Scholar for Superior Academic Achievement and was presented the Parker School Certificate for Achievement in International and Comparative Law. He was also elected graduation speaker, an honor exclusively granted to the most outstanding student of the Master of Laws graduating class at Columbia Law School to speak at graduation on behalf of the class. He contributed substantial work to the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees in Makati City, Philippines, and the United Nations Development Program headquarters in New York, USA. Whereas the outstanding performance of Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo was acknowledged by the Columbia Law School, which can be found at their website and at the Rappler website. Whereas because of the academic achievements, excellence, and qualifications of Attorney Patrick Simon Si Perillo, he was hired at Ateneo Law School as professorial lecturer in law, moot court advisor, and thesis panelist and supervisor. At De La Salle University as assistant professor, professorial lecturer, and at Columbia Law School as research assistant and as staff associate to Professor Laurie F. Damrosch, President of the American Society of International Law, and as teaching assistant for Columbia's International Summer Program. Whereas Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo was able to work at various agencies of the government, such as the Supreme Court of the Philippines, particularly as Court Attorney 4, Court Attorney 5, and Court Attorney 6 at the Office of the Associate Justice Presbytero J. Velasco, Jr. Moreover, he will be joining the President of the Republic of the Philippines under the Office of the Deputy Executive Secretary for Legal Affairs. Whereas the outstanding accomplishment of Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo as a student, as an educator, and as lawyer is worth emulating by the younger generation of the province, and the exemplary honors given by him to the province of Camarines Sur as well as to the country deserves recognition and commendation by the Sanggunian Panlalawigan of Camarines Sur. Now therefore, Mr. Chairman, without further ado, I move for the approval of resolution commending Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo, a native of Camarines Sur, for giving exemplary honors to the Philippines and most especially to the province of Camarines Sur for having been an outstanding graduate of LLM class of 2014 and elected graduation speaker at the commencement ceremony of the Columbia Law School, Columbia University in the city of New York, state of New York in the United States of America. Be approved.
Any second?
I second.
Duly seconded by Honorable Nopra and the Honorable Simando. Any remarks, objection? Hearing none, the same is approved.
With this, my chairman, I move for the suspension of the rules.
Rule suspended.
May I call in?
What's the pleasure of the Honorable Nopra?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Pagkatapos po madanggo ko ang napakagayon na istorya sa pagkikang resolusyon na sa tuntugang na provincial board member, Mr. Chairman. Mano daw po tayo sarong napakagayon na pagkakataon na madangog ang mga kaakian kang interong probinsyang Camarines Sur ang sarong tao na nagtaong inspirasyon as in matao pang honor sa satong probinsya. Mano daw po, Mr. Chairman, kung itutugot po kan sa satong bisita, magaganda po siyang panahon na makatao man yung pahayag sa satuyan.
Okay. So after the awarding, we'll give Attorney Perillo.
Yeah. Yes, Mr. Chairman. That's why I move to suspend the rules for us to give the floor to our guest, our honoree, Mr. Chairman. But before that, may I request our presiding officer, our vice governor, and my colleagues to be in front to award the certificate of commendation to Attorney Patrick. And same, may I ask the Attorney Patrick and the family to be here in front for the awarding.
Okay, so may we request all the honorable members to please
May I, Mr. Chairman. The province of Camarines Sur, this certificate of commendation is hereby awarded to Attorney Patrick Simon C. Perillo in recognition of his academic achievements, excellence, qualifications for having been an outstanding graduate of Master of Laws, LLM class of 2014 and elected graduation speaker at the commencement ceremony of the Columbia Law School, Columbia University of the City of New York, State of New York in the United States of America, that brought exemplary honors to the Philippines and most especially to the province of Camarines Sur. Given this 11th day of November 2014 at the Legislative Building, Provincial Capital Complex, Cadlan Pilic, province of Camarines Sur, signed Hilmar S. Macamara, Vice Governor Fortunato C. Peña, Miguel Luis R. Villaferte, Governor, Camsur. upon the request of board member Nupra, Mr. Chairman, may we hear some inspiring message from Attorney Patrick.
The floor is now given to the honoree.
Distinguished officials and staff of the province of Camarines Sur, good morning. Nagpapasalamat po akong dakula na nagkaigwa po akong pagkakataon na magdigdis sa Indo sa Kapitolyo. Dakula po ining karangalan para siyempre sa kuya po at saka sa sakuyang pamilya. Sana po magkaigwa ako ng pagkakataon na magsirbi as in magpromote kang probinsyata. So, iyan po ang pagtatrabahuhan ta. Salamat pong maray.
Thank you very much, Attorney. One minute recess. Again, congratulations to our honoree. Session will now resume.
Mr. Chairman, may I move for the recognition of Board Member Nupra?
The Honorable Nupra is now recognized.
Thank you, Majority Floor Leader, Mr. Chairman. Yan po, alipot man sana, na may gusto lang po akong iklaro, ilinaw na po, Mr. Chairman, lalong-lalo na po para sa mga tugang kong mga tagalibmanan. Bago po ako magpalagos, Mr. Chairman, may babanggito na po akong tulong petsa. Tani po, labi kalaga, dahil na po ako magpaparapaliwanag pa ng halawig na maray. Babanggitong ko na po, inot on October 7, Sangguniang Panlalawigan Session, e-live session, tayan po nasa YouTube. October 21, regular session, again po, e-live, nasa YouTube po yan. October 22, e-live session, nasa YouTube po yan. Tadyan po, madadala na padagos, sigabos ko mga paliwanag, reparo, pagtuyaw, argumento, istorya. Tungkol po duman sa resolusyon number 14-248 kanlibmanan. Ini po si resolusyon na sa pag-utang kambanuan ng libmanan sa halagang 150 million pesos. Ang nag-sponsor po kayo ni si Kagawad Ariel Urino. So malino po tungkol ini sa resolusyon pag-loan kambanuan ng libmanan. Ako po Mr. Chairman, nakiulay mag-explicar ngunyan niyan. Ta base po digdi sa sertifikasyon na pigluwas na kang sa tuyang secretariat. Asin po ini naresibi na duman sa munisipyo Kambanuan na Libmanan, malinaw pong sinasabi digdi na ang nasambit na resolusyon aprobado na po on review kanakaging special session last October 28, 2014, Mr. Chairman. Ngunyan po, anbut lang linawo ni Board Member Darius Boboy Nupra na ang resolusyon pong ini, ako po nagkontra ko kani. Ang boto po ni Darius Boboy Nupra, malinaw po, no. I was against, I am against this resolution. Nagkontra po si Board Member Nopra. So, malino po, by majority vote, naaprobaran ini, and si Board Member Boboy Nopra po, dahil po ako nagbago kan sa kuyang desisyon. Dahil po ako nagbari kan sa kuyang paninindugan. Mala po nga ni, takin special session, kalos October 8, October 28, special session, dangan lang po, tamayong video, kampanaw na ito. Halos gabos na pigpresentar pong motion a pabor sa pag-aprobar ka nasambit na resolusyon kambanwa na libmanan po nagkontra, nag-upunir si Board Member Nopra. Kaya katapos-tapos po pagkabot sa botohan, kontra po, no, ang boto ni Board Member Nopra. Ini po, piglilinaw ko lang ni tad, ang mga kapaliwanagan ko po gabos, sinabi ko na yaw na po duman sa tulong petsa kan nakaaging mga sesyon kan sanggunyang panalawigan. Kung tano po ako, padagos sa minaopunir kan siri na kaisipan kan mga lokal na opisyales kan banwaan na limanan. Kaya po ang kupong linawon ini, takan October 22, pagkatapos pa akong manindugan digdi sa sanggunyang panalawigan, na ako po nanindugan, laban po sa resolusyon na ini, kinagaan po kayan. Daing swerte po, iguan nagpaluas ng bareta, nakabot duman sa libmanan, na ako nalugod ang nag-igot-igot na nag-i-sponsor po da para maaprobaran ang nasambit na pag-utang. Aram po nindo, testigos ko po, ang kaglalang as in gabos na nagdadalan digdi, day ko po yung ginibo, imposible yan. Tako nga niya nagkukontra. Kundi po dahil sa baretang yan po, nagtaunin dalan yan, na magkaigwan yung pagkaribong duman sa banwaan mi. Dahil ko po aram kung ano ang intensyon, ano ito kayo po ang magpaluas ng siring kay na bareta, Mr. Chairman. So, ini po, piglilinaw ko lang, taro ko niyan, si Board Member Nopra, nadawag po ako sa butuan. Nadawag ako sa butuan po, ginibo ko ang sakuya makakaya, abot lang po duman si makakaya ko sa panahon na ini. Pero linawang ko po giraray para sa mga taga-banwaan kan libmanan. Ako po, dahil nagbago kan sakuyang desisyon, dahil ko nagbari kan sa kuyang paninindugan, ang boto po ni Board Member Nopra sa paglon kang banuan na libmanan sa rupong dakulaon na no na dainong kamabago, Mr. Chairman. Salamat po, Giraray. Salamat.
Thank you, Honorable Nopra.
Calendar of Business. Committee Report. Committee on Franchises.
Thank you. I have 7 items, Mr. Chairman, and 4 of which are letters coming from Adriano B. Consunji, Chief Commission Secretariat, and 2 of which are letters coming from Attorney Elenito M. Bagalihog, Chief Water Rights Division, and 1 letter coming from Mrs. Ana Silvia B. Alcisto, General Manager Camarines Sur, 1 Electric Cooperative, requesting for the issuance of a certificate and posting in the bulletin board for at least 15 to 30 days. So the committee, Mr. Chairman, apparently thoroughly scrutinized seeing the all documents submitted by these applicants, found it legal and has complied with the requirements. And then the committee deemed it proper to approve the request. So this representation, Mr. Chairman, Chairman of the Committee on Franchise, directed the Secretary or the Secretariat to issue a corresponding certificate thereof and post the request in our bulletin for 15 or 30 days. And I move for its approval, Mr. Chairman.
Anybody seconding? Seconded by the Honorable Nopra. Any remarks, objection? Hearing none, the same committee report is hereby approved and adopted.
Thank you, thank you.
Can laws in review.
The Honorable Shimando.
Mr. Chairman, this refers to my committee report of Committee on Laws in Review. There are 30 items included therein. May I move for the approval of the report?
So, any second. Duly seconded by the Honorable Pakamara and Noble. Any remarks? Objection? Hearing none, same is approved and adopted.
Business for the day. Number one, the inclusion of Honorable Pakamara.
Yes, Mr. Chairman. My inclusion was a resolution ordinance authorizing Honorable Miguel Luis R. Villafuerte, Governor, Province of Camarines Sur, to enter into a memorandum agreement by and between the province of provincial government of Camarines Sur and the Department of Labor and Employment, Regional Office 5 through Mr. Nathaniel V. Lacambra, Regional Director DOLE, for the implementation of DOLE Integrated Livelihood and Emergency Employment Program and appropriate funds thereof. Mr. Chairman, I was aware that my colleagues are given a copy of this draft resolution, and since DOLE has so many projects, the provincial government can avail of it. One requirement, Mr. Chairman, is that the Sangguniang Panlawigan must or should pass a resolution authorizing the governor. And on the word assess, nakakapod naman si mga explanations on how to avail and ano ang ma-avail kang provincial government. So, with this, Mr. Chairman, I move for its approval.
In a second, duly seconded by the Honorable Nopra. Any objection? Remarks? The Honorable Nopra is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Primo, I was the one who second. Ang ano ko lang po, Tigdi, following po itong mga paliwanag ni Board Member Simando, lalo duman sa committee report niya ngunyan. And since this will involve funds, provincial funds, Mr. Chairman, bako daw po na dapat resolution ordinance, Mr. Chairman?
By the way, excuse me, Mr. Chairman, this has nothing to do with my resolution ordinance. It's on Attorney Simando's sponsored resolution. Bako po yan, Digdi.
This is only a resolution?
Yeah. Hindi pong resolution. It is a resolution ordinance. However, ang pinag-tackle po, ang pinag-clarify po ni Board Member Nukla is on the resolutions being sponsored by Board Member Simando, wherein sa title po nakaglang naman resolution, bakong resolution ordinance. So ito pang, pero bakong digdi. So it has nothing to do with my ordinance, Mr. Chairman.
So you're moving for a resolution ordinance? Or?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. Yes, okay. And so, it was approved. And it was seconded.
Duly seconded already. Any other objections or remarks? There being none, the same resolution is approved.
Inclusion of Honorable Julia.
The inclusion of Honorable Julia.
This resolution condemning the ruthless killing of Barangay Captain Simio Mendoza sa Barangay Binanuanan Grande, Calabanga, Camarines Sur, and urging the Philippine National Police and other law enforcement agencies to investigate for the fast resolution of the case. It has come to the attention of the Sangguniang Panlalawigan of Camarines Sur about the death of Barangay Captain Simio Mendoza of Barangay Binanuanan Grande, Calabanga, Camarines Sur, last November 6, 2014. The latest tragedy involving the killing of Barangay Captain Simeon Mendoza who was robbed and killed in his own residence in Barangay Binanuana Grande, Calabanga, has tried to resist robbery wherein perpetrators taking away lump sum of cash. The death of Barangay Captain Mendoza has caused fear and worry to the people of Calabanga, Camarinesur, as well as the general public of the effort of the Philippine National Police and the different crime and their capability to secure the populace and containing criminality of the province. And now therefore, Mr. Chairman, I move resolution condemning the ruthless killing of Barangay Captain Mendoza, Simon Mendoza of Barangay Binanuana Grande, Calabanga, Camarines Sur, and urging the Philippine National Police and other law enforcement agencies to investigate for the past resolution of the case be approved, Mr. Chairman.
Any second. Duly seconded by Honorable Bengua and Nopra. Any remarks, objection? Hearing none, same is approved.
And another resolution, Mr. Chairman. Resolution expressing deepest sympathy and condolences to the bereaved family of the late Barangay Captain si Mendoza of Barangay Binanuana Grande of Calabanga, Camarines Sur. I move for this approval, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, any second? Duly seconded by Honorable Nopra and Bengua. Any objection? Hearing none, the same is approved.
Inclusions of Honorable Simando.
The Honorable Simando is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. There are three resolutions, proposed resolutions, namely, resolution authorizing the Governor Luis Miguel Luis R. Villaverde on behalf of the provincial government of Camarines Sur to donate a portion of a parcel of land situated at Cadlan Pili, Camarines Sur in favor of the Supreme Court of the Philippines that will be used as site of the Hall of Justice Pili, Camarines Sur. Proposed resolution authorizing Honorable Miguel Luis R. Villaverde to enter into and sign a memorandum of agreement for and in behalf of the province of Camarines Sur with National Food Authority regarding the implementation of expanded rice loan program in the province of Camarines Sur. And finally, resolution authorizing Governor Miguel Luis R. Villaverde on behalf of the province of Camarines Sur to donate 20 heads of deers to Hacienda de Naga Sports Club Incorporated. May I move, Mr. Chairman, for the approval of these three resolutions.
Yes, the Honorable Nopra is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. With all due respect to our Chairman of the Committee on Laws and Review, our Bar Tapnacher. Mr. Chairman, bago po akong mag-sekundar kan mga resolusyon na yun, especially po dito sa draft resolution number 1, resolution authorizing the Governor Miguel Luis R. Villaverde to donate a parcel of land situated at Cadlan Piri, Camarines Sur in favor of the Supreme Court of the Philippines that will be used as site of the Hall of Justice Pili, Camarines Sur. Now, Mr. Chairman, ano po sa pagtubod kan sa tuyang ni Board Member si Mando, mano daw po ko nang sa tuyang ipasar, tama daw po na ang sa kuyang suggestion na inikay po ang resolution ordinance. Kasi po, base po yun duman sa mga aksyon niya na sa nakaagi, purok sa report niya ngunyan. Asin po sa klase, kanintensyon, na ini po permanente, makong panandalian sana. So ano daw po ang masasabi kan sa itong, kung okay po sa iyo po.
Well, frankly, these resolutions were transmitted by the office of the governor through the office of the legal officer of the province of Camarines Sur. Now, we believe, Mr. Chairman, that although previously we consider that matters involving similar subject require an ordinance, but we believe that a resolution will do in this particular instances.
Anyway, Mr. Chairman, ako po nag-question sa naman.
Thank you.
Okay. Lord Thank Member. You. So, are you seconding it, Honorable Lopra? Duly seconded by the Honorable Lopra. Any objection? Hearing none. The same is approved. Next item, please.
Resolution authorizing Honorable Governor Miguel S. R. Villafuerte to enter into a and sign a memorandum of agreement for in behalf of the province of Camarines Sur with National Food Authority.
That has been approved. That has been approved. Okay. The three resolutions.
The business for today under transferred items from reference of business taken from the first reading, Your Honor, F2A1, resolution designating and or appointing Honorable Warren A. Senior to preside over administrative case number 002-240-2014 entitled Francisco Ramirez Trilla III, complainant versus Angie Belmonte Noble, respondent for grave misconduct, Onion Bank session.
Mr. Chairman, this is a resolution designating and or appointing Honorable Warren A. Senior to preside over administrative case number 002-2014 entitled Francisco Ramirez Trilla III, complainant versus Angie Belmonte Noble, respondent for grave misconduct. For grave misconduct. May I move, Mr. Chairman, for the approval of this resolution?
Anybody seconding the motion? Duly seconded by the Honorable Nopra and Pakamara. Any objection? Hearing none, save is approved.
Resolution amending Rule 1, preliminary provisions of the resolutions number 150, series of 2013, entitled Resolution adopting the rules of procedure on the investigation of administrative disciplinary cases against elected municipal officials as embodied in Resolution number 278, series of 2011, as amended by Resolution number 13, series of 2013.
May I move, Mr. Chairman, for the approval of the said resolution?
Anybody seconded? Duly seconded by the Honorable Nopra and Pakamara. Any objection? Hearing none, same is approved.
Resolution urging the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources and the Department of Environment and Natural Resources to issue warning to fisher folk communities in the coastal areas in the province of Camarines Sur against the slaughter and eating of marine sea turtles.
We recognize Board Member Olya.
The Honorable Olya is recognized.
Mr. Chairman, pursuant to Republic Act 9147, otherwise known as Wildlife Resources Conservation and Protection Act, prohibiting fisher folks to catch all kinds of turtle species in the country, is also a policy of the state to conserve wildlife resources and their habitats for sustainability and promote ecological balance and enhance biological diversity. Whereas marine or sea turtles are reptiles characterized by flipper-like arms used for swimming and flattened body shape with a protective carapace and mostly feed on seagrass, plankton, jellyfish, and sea sponges. The slaughter of the turtle, cooking and eating them is very lethal for human consumption due to the danger of high mineral toxins that turtle acquire from eating sea sponges found in deep sea corals. Despite being a delicacy in several regions, turtle meat causes hospitalization and even death in some part of country brought by food poisoning. Although meat fillets of sea turtles are fatty and is commonly of good quality, nonetheless, there are seen poisonous and not safe for eating. Deaths in certain areas in Sorsogon and Masbate provinces have been reported, particularly children after eating total meat, which also causes dizziness, vomiting, and stomach pains. Now, therefore, Mr. Chairman, I move a resolution urging the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, BFAR, and the Department of Employment, Environment and Natural Resources, DNR, to issue warning to fisher folks communities and the coastal areas in the province of Camarines Sur against the slaughter and eating of marine sea turtles.
Duly seconded by the Honorable Senior and Nupra. Any objection? Hearing none, the same is approved.
A resolution formally naming the composition of the various standing committees of the Sangguniang Pananawigan.
Mr. Chairman, this is a resolution formally naming the composition of the various standing committees of the Sangguniang Pananawigan. May I move for the approval of this resolution?
Yes, anybody seconding the motion? The Honorable Pakamara is seconding the motion. So any remarks, objection? Hearing none, the same is approved.
Other matters?
Other matters?
Announcements?
Yes,
yes, Mr. Chairman. Clarification lang po, Mr. Chairman. During our August session, it was the chairman of the Committee on Finance Appropriation sponsored the disapproval of the 2014 annual budget of our town, San Jose. Unfortunately, until this very moment, Mr. Chairman, 3 months, 2 to 3 months have passed. May opening nagluwas na resolution. So may I for signature? For signature po. Nasa taas. That's all, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman, if there are no other matters to be discussed, may I move for the adjournment of this session?
Yes, there is a motion to adjourn. What's the pleasure of the Honorable Noble?
Mr. Chairman, pertaining to the administrative case between, I think, Mayor Pilapil. As of now, I've only the lone members of that preside. I think Bukal Simando inhibit that, and then Bukal Naval also resign. So may I know now the two members so that they can now proceed to the committee hearing, Mr. Chairman. So I'm only the one to the case of Mayor Pilapil.
With regard to the problem of Board Member Noble, may we inform Board Member Noble that considering the resignation of Board Member Naval from the committee, we have designated and or appointed Board Member Hilmar Pakamara as a replacement of Board Member Naval. So actually, there are two remaining members, Mr. Chairman, that will constitute a quorum. Although this representation has inhibited himself as chairman for reasons already given before this honorable body, the Committee on Administrative Cases can pursue the hearing of that administrative case.
It is only pertaining, Mr. Chairman, to the case of Mayor Pilapil, so that he can now proceed
so
to that.
You have committee. Two members already at the Honorable Simando. So it is Honorable Pakamara and yourself.
Honorable
Pakamara.
Pakamara.
And then,
yes, he has been officially designated under resolution which you have approved.
Okay.
Just a while ago.
So you have two members already and on the case of Mayor Pilapil. So any other matters? There was already a pending motion to adjourn. Duly seconded by the Honorable Nopra. The session is adjourned. Thank you. Good morning. God bless you all.